We want to solve the given rational inequality and express the solution using interval notation. The first step is to write the inequality as a single quotient on the left and zero on the right. To do this, we first add 3 to both sides and write the inequality as the quantity 5x minus 1 divided by the quantity 6x plus 7 plus 3, which we write as plus 3 divided by 1 less than 0. And now we need to add on the right by obtaining the least common denominator, which is the quantity 6x plus 7, which indicates we multiply 3 divided by 1 by the quantity 6x plus 7 divided by the quantity 6x plus 7. Notice now we do have a common denominator of 6x plus 7, and the numerator is now 5x minus 1 plus 3 times the quantity 6x plus 7. And now we need to simplify the numerator. Let's do this on the side. We have 5x minus 1 plus 3 times the quantity 6x plus 7. Clearing the parentheses, we have 5x minus 1 plus 18x plus 21. And combining like terms, 5x plus 18x is 23x. Negative 1 plus 21 gives us plus 20. So now we can write the inequality as the quantity 23x plus 20 divided by the quantity 6x plus 7 less than 0. Now that we've completed step 1, step 2, we determine the zeros of the numerator and denominator. To find the zero of the numerator, we set 23x plus 20 equal to 0 and solve for x. We subtract 20 on both sides, which gives us 23x equals negative 20. Divide both sides by 23, and we have x equals negative 20 23rds for the zero of the numerator. Let's record this below. And now to find the zero of the denominator, we need to solve the equation 6x plus 7 equals 0. Next step, subtract 7 on both sides, and then divide by 6. Simplifying, we have x equals negative 7 sixths as the zero of the denominator. Step 3, we now plot the zeros on the number line. The zeros of the numerator are either open or closed points based upon the inequality symbol. The zeros of the denominator are always open points. To begin, notice negative 20 23rds is greater than negative 1. And negative 7 sixths is less than negative 1. So let's plot negative 7 sixths on the left. Because this is 0 of the denominator, it's always an open point. And then looking at the 0 of the numerator, this is when the fraction on the left is equal to 0, and 0 less than 0 is false, which indicates you make an open point on the number line for the 0 of the numerator. So let's say negative 20 23rds is here. Now, if you're not sure about where these go on the number line, of course, we can always go to the calculator to get their decimal approximations of negative 20 divided by 23 and negative 7 divided by 6. And we can see that negative 7 sixths is to the left of negative 20 23rds. I do want to mention if the inequality symbol was less than or equal, then for the zero of the numerator, we would have a closed point on the number line, because then the inequality would be satisfied. So if the inequality symbol is less than or greater than, the zero of the numerator will always be an open point. If it's less than or equal to or greater than or equal to, the zero of the numerator would always be a closed point. And now we need to test each interval, each subinterval, to determine which intervals are true and which are false. Whichever intervals are true will be the solution to the original inequality. When performing the test, we could use original inequality, but it's much easier to compare to zero, so we use the equivalent inequality when comparing to zero, meaning this inequality here. Now let's go ahead and pick our test values first. Starting on the right, let's use x equals 0. 0 is greater than negative 20 23rds. On the left of negative 7 sixths, let's use negative 2. Now we need to find a value between negative 7 sixths and negative 20 23rds. Let's use negative 21 23rds. And just to verify that value is between negative 7/6 and negative 20 23rds, let's go back to the calculator. Negative 21 divided by 23, notice, is between negative 7/6 and negative 20 23rds. And now, because we're comparing to zero, we don't actually care about the exact values of the numerator and denominator. We simply have to determine whether the numerator and denominator are positive or negative for the given test values. So let's first test x equals negative 2. When x is negative 2, the numerator is going to be 23 times negative 2, which is negative 46, plus 20, which is negative, divided by, when x is negative 2, the denominator is going to be negative 12 plus 7, which is negative. A negative divided by a negative is equal to a positive. A positive value is never going to be less than 0, and therefore the inequality is false, and the interval on the left is false. Now let's test x equals 0, and then we'll use the calculator to test negative 21 23rds. So when x equals 0, notice the numerator is going to be 20, the denominator is going to be 7, or we have a positive divided by a positive, which is positive. A positive value is not less than 0. The interval on the right is false. And now let's go to the calculator to test x equals negative 21 23rds. Notice when x is negative 21 23rds, the numerator is negative, the denominator is positive. A negative divided by a positive is going to be negative. A negative value is always less than 0, and therefore the interval in the middle is true. And the graph of the solution is this interval here in the middle. To finish, we'll go ahead and give the interval using interval notation. The solution is the open interval from negative 7/6 to negative 20 23rds. Because the endpoints are not included, we have an open interval and we use rounded parentheses to the left and right. Just in case you're wondering, if you want to express the solution using inequalities, we would say x is greater than negative 7/6 and less than negative 20 23rds. But again, our directions do say to use interval notation. I hope you found this helpful.